This is Colin Dixon with Endscreen Media, and I'm at DW 2018 in Los Angeles, and I'm speaking with Sam Tolles. And Sam Tolles is Senior Vice President of Digital New Platforms at MGM. Now, one of the things that came up on the panel is the monetization issue. There's a lot of skepticism about if SVOD services can really go ahead and make money. And, well, we've seen at least once. We know that Netflix made money in 2017 for the first time, which is great. They're now a profitable service. But for smaller services, it's much tougher, right? So how do they go about making money? How are you going to make money with the Stargate portal?
Well, I think it's a challenge, obviously, but we have to remember that OTT is a brand new business. Netflix didn't exist but a few years ago in its current form. I remember a time before House of Cards when Netflix was just a weird collection of strange films and whatnot. And really what it boils down to is that over time, as models change, new businesses emerge. You know, cable did not make money. The original sort of cable channels did not make money for many, many years. But ultimately, I think the average was 7 years before they started turning a profit. And we knew that all of those companies, many of them became billion-dollar businesses, multi-billion-dollar businesses. And, Viacom and Discovery and Scripps, they all, exploded. But before that, they were new businesses, too, in the very early days of cable. In the same way that new platforms are sort of going through the discovery process of how to find audience, how to acquire subscribers, how to manage churn, subscription acquisition costs, TAM and TAC and all of the sort of acronyms that we use in the industry. But ultimately, these services that survive, and I think you'll see some consolidation where, groups of services that serve a similar niche ultimately begin to combine to be the sort of the focal point for that niche. Certain services that don't have enough audience ultimately go away. But in all business, the strong survive and grow. And like Netflix, they will grow and find that sort of tipping point where they're profitable, and that profitability will grow and grow and grow. You said something very interesting in the panel that only 6 million households were true cord cutters, meaning they did not have rabbit ears and they did not have cable, right? That's a tiny fraction of the global universe of content buyers in this country. Imagine what that landscape looks like when there's 50 million of those people. And the options that they have are, well, I'm not building a cable bundle. I'm picking the services that I want. And there's this service that's Stargate, and I'm a Stargate fan. And there's this service that's, Star Trek, and I'm a Star Trek fan. And they kind of put these pieces together along with their, I love baseball, I'm going to get the MLB package. Yep. I love soccer, I'm going to get the soccer package. And so really giving that consumer the choice, it takes time for one model to sort of, move into the past and other models to sort of come into the future. And that's the thing that really excites me about being at MGM, because we are looking at a 360 view. We're selling actively to all buyers in the traditional landscape, but we're positioning ourselves for the future by experimenting and ultimately growing businesses in the digital landscape.
It seems like MGM has such a rich catalog. Are you looking at digital as an opportunity to reinvigorate some of your older brands as well?
So I think that's a really important part of what digital can do. A lot of studios are very protective of their core IP in the sense of maybe being overly protective. If a brand that they think has this incredible resonance but hasn't been around for a while ultimately doesn't get reimagined or doesn't get to be introduced to a new audience, you can say, what does Weekend at Bernie's mean to a 20-year-old? And they're like, isn't there a meme with Bernie Sanders that was Weekend at Bernie's? I've never seen the movie, right? So it's about how do we take our iconic IP that has been so meaningful and so emotionally connected to previous generations, have new storytellers come up with new ideas around introducing those brands and reimagining them to connect with new generations. And what's great about that is those new generations go, wow, I just saw the Stargate digital series. It's the first time I've ever seen Stargate. I'm going to go dive in and check out what is Stargate, what that world looks like. And they discover the history of it. They actually are brought back. And that is hugely valuable for us from a library monetization standpoint, but also from, keeping brands relevant and moving them forward.
And are you going to invest in new digital properties as well?
Absolutely. I mean, ultimately, whether any of my mentors in the business have always told me, like, it's about a great idea. If you don't have a great idea, you don't have a show, you don't have a movie, you don't have a digital series, you don't have anything, quite frankly. And so I have a terrific young development team who is constantly iterating not only on how we reimagine our IP, but looking at content and scripts and pilots and digital series that are coming from the amazing vast landscape of digital native creators. And we're really putting this fine filter, which is what a studio should do. We need to be the arbiters of what is ultimately the best quality content imaginable, and finding those sort of amazing next generation of digital creators and empowering them to tell their stories using our library, but potentially taking one of their ideas and saying, let's invest in that, let's run with that, let's bring that to a platform, let's put that on one of our platforms. And so it's really, I think it's probably the most exciting thing that I do is to work with this next generation of talented creators and empower them to make amazing stories.
It sounds like a really exciting time for MGM, getting a shot in the arm from the digital market, it sounds like.
We're a tiny part of their business today, but I anticipate over the years we're going to be the biggest part of their business.
Let's hope so. Sam, it's been great talking with you.
Great to talk to you as well. Thank you.
Thank you. This has been Colin Dixon with Endscreen Media.